got cooking, what you gonna cook, what you gonna stop by the store and purchase it, what you gonna, what's ready to take. But give me, if you will, give me just 10 cookies. And I'm gonna label this keys to your life. The keys to your life. And this description comes from the book of John, the 16th chapter, and the 16th verse. It says, Jesus is talking to his disciples. Now, I want you to pay close attention as I walk you through this moment, amen? As I walk you through this moment, I'm going to ask everybody to stay still for just a moment. If you got a pencil or a piece of paper, I want you to write, these are keys to your life. I promise you, if you just follow me for a moment, I promise you, you'll get what you need. Jesus says to his disciples, he says, a little while you will no longer see me. And again, a little while and you will see me. He says, then some of his disciples said to another, what does he mean by saying a little while we will see him, and then a little while we won't see him? They said, what do you mean by this, a little while? Do you not know what he is talking about? Jesus knows that they were wanting to ask him questions. So he said to them, are you discussing among yourselves what I meant when I said, a little while you will see me, then a little while you won't see me, and then you'll see me again? He says, very truly, truly, I tell you, you will weep and mourn. And I want you to pay attention to this. But the world will rejoice. You will have pain. And in your pain will turn to joy. When the woman is in labor, she has pain because her hour has come. But when her child is born, she no longer remembers the anguish because of the joy of having brought forth a human being. To say just a word. Listen, I've been experiencing this afternoon, this whole Holy Week experience for me, and I keep thinking about Jesus' Last Supper, and then there is a moment where he leaves the supper. He tells them what he's going to go through. He says Peter's going to deny him, and he says Judah is going to betray him. Amen? And these are all the people that were surrounding him that were supposed to be his running buddy, that was supposed to be his good friends. And but then he leaves that dinner, he leaves that supper, he leaves what is called the Passover. And then listen, he's so concerned about what lie ahead, he goes to his favorite praying place, the Garden of Gethsemane. All right, if I get y'all in Bible study, I won't have to spend so much time on it, but that's another. But he goes to his favorite praying place, which is the Garden of Gethsemane. And there, and so, I just want you to, my first point, because I got to move this along. My first point, listen, when you're in your deepest moment of anguish and you're disturbed and anxious and you don't know what's going to happen to you, you don't know what tomorrow is going to look like, you know, have you ever been there when they see that everything and everybody has turned back on you? I want you to first, Jesus goes to his favorite place to pray, but then he takes his friend. Everybody needs some friends. Yeah. You're not an island unto yourself. All those who want to be big and bad, I'm telling you now, you need some friends. Yeah. All right? So he calls the sons of Zebedee and some others to come and go with me to this moment in which I'm getting ready to face. I'm going to my favorite praying place. You want to have a place where and you've set aside to pray. No, what I mean, you have to have a place to go and pray. Yes. Right. Every now and then, I sneak along to my clothes closet, turn off the light, lay prostrate on the floor, and begin to pray. I don't want my life. I don't want to be wrong.
That's right.
That's my praying place.
Yes.
Everybody should have a moment, a place where they can retreat to pray. You're going to need some friends,
yeah.
And you're going to need a praying place. And so they follow him to the Garden of Gethsemane, and as they follow him, now look, I know you know the story, right? For some of you who've been coming to Bible study, he calls them to the innermost comes out, he sees them asleep. They couldn't stay awake. I have newfound respect. They were there.
Amen.
At least they were there.
Amen.
Amen. At least they were there. Sum up something. You can always listen, you need to count up the cost. Look in your way and count those people who will go with you to your secret moment when you're facing some troubling times, when you're involved in some mess. Stay with you. We may fall asleep sometimes, but we don't go with you where you need to go in order for you to get to where you need to go.
Yeah.
But y'all need to make a survey of your life. See, some of y'all got some folk hanging around that just there, just
all right,
as fans.
Hanging up.
Let me say fans, because I got a lot of singers in here. Mm. See, there's a difference between fans and followers.
All right.
See, a fan will stay with you. A fan will go with you only until the next great singer comes along.
Yeah. All right. All right.
Oh, that's all right. Oh, great, great, great. Oh, that Rick can sing, y'all. Rick can sing. Rick can, that boy can sing. They got to help Rick sing. Sing, Rick. Sing, Rick, until somebody else comes along and they're hooping and hollering and get a pitch higher than Rick. Rick does all right, but I like that one over there. But a follower?
Oh, yeah.
A follower gonna stick with you, Rick. We gonna, you ask me to go to the garden for somebody with you so you can pray because you know you got hell on face. Tomorrow I'll go right with you. Yeah. No matter who else is singing melodious song, I'm right there with you, brother. I might not stay awake,
but I'm
there. But physically I'm there. I got the ministry of presence.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's number one. Number two. That's number one and two. Find yourself some friends
right. That
will go with you till the end.
Right.
And then find them with you going to your secret praying place. If people in your life don't know how to pray, then what? Come here. Let's go, Lord. I'm going to have to ask you to edit that. If you don't have people in your life that don't know how to pray, then you're in danger.
Yeah.
Amen.
You're in danger. Amen. You got to find some folk who knows how to pray because life is hard. Have you ever seen the news?
Yeah.
There is war and rumor of war.
Yes.
Yeah.
You got to find some folk who knows how to pray.
Yeah.
That's right. You got to find some. Then the other thing. Then Jesus goes into the innermost garden. And this is what Jesus says. Now, you know, Jesus is struggling. For those of you who want to be so Holy Ghost filled and find baptized, I'm going to let you know Jesus didn't want to do this.
That's right.
Amen.
All right. Yeah.
Jesus goes into the garden. Jesus says, if you will.
That's right.
I don't want to go through this, Jesus.
That's right.
I don't want to face my poor tomorrow. I might be fine. I don't. If you can, if you will, take this cup from me.
Yes, yes.
The mortgage is due. I might be set off. If you will, take this cup from me. My husband, my wife, my children are about to leave me. If you will, take this cup from me.
The third thing I want you to know, you got to be flat out and honest with God.
Yes, that's true.
Don't pretend. I don't want to go through this, Jesus.
Yeah.
I don't want to have to go and bear this burden. If you will, let it go before you. The first thing he says, our Father, Abba.
Yes.
You recognize who Jesus is. I know you can do it, Jesus. I know you can do it, God. Our Father. Father, I know you can. I know you can. How many of you know that the Lord can?
Yes.
Yes.
I know you can. I know you can. I know you can. I know you can. But if you will, let this cup go before me. Because that's the truth. We don't want to go through anything. Y'all know that.
Yeah.
Stop telling God. We ain't trying to go through nothing.
Nope.
The good news is that we got Jesus to go with us and some good friend that's going to stick by you.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. And go before us.
Yeah. But then he says something that shows forth his faith. I don't want to go through it, God. 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 But it is your will. But if it's your will, then let your will
be done.
Yes.
Amen.
It's a master prayer.
Yes.
Jesus hears the prayers, but you know what knows? You know who knows what is better for you than yourself? It is Jesus.
Yes.
It's God.
Yes.
You may not want to go through it. I got you. I got that. But the will of God will be done.
Yes.
So he recognized, but you know, out of everything I've said, oh God, that's my Friday. That's my Friday morning. I'm in anguish and I'm going through hell because of what I'm about to face. The Bible says Jesus, blood, drops of sweat, drops of blood.
Yes.
That's my Friday. Everybody gonna have some Friday moments in their life.
Yes.
That's the Friday. Then comes Saturday, he goes to the cross.
Mm-hmm.
And all hell breaks loose. There's confusion everywhere. The disciples are looking around. But what happened? I thought this was a man of God. Jesus could have come down from the cross. He could have saved himself. What happened? Why? There's always some confusion and pain. Everybody's in pain now, right? Because they're experiencing the loss. Look back at your trouble. The first thing you experience is the trepidation and the problem head on. That's your Friday moment. And then you go through the pain of experiencing the loss, because now they're wondering what they're going to do. And let's be clear about it. They're all in hiding. The Roman government is looking for them.
Yes.
They're going to find anybody who's associated with you.
Yes.
Rick, I'm going to stay with you. I'm going to be disappointed because I ain't going to see you. Then I'm going to, you know, but I'm going to run because everybody who I'm associated with you, they're going to come after me next.
Yeah.
You know, that's what's going on. That's the real moment. That's the real part. But and everybody is in a moment of confusion and pain. When you're going through your going through, you're going to be in a moment of confusion and pain because you're going to feel like God has let you down.
Yes.
You pray and 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 you fell prostrate and still God has not come through to answer your prayer. Now you're experiencing loss and pain.
Oh, yeah.
That's your Saturday experience. But that's not where the story ends.
Amen.
Yeah.
That's not where your journey ends. As a matter of fact, if you stay faithful to an all-faithful God, then your journey is about to really begin. You're just getting ready to celebrate all, and you're just focused on what is God bringing you to what is good. See, you get stuck. You'll get stuck in the pain and grief and loss. Then all you can do, I met some people like that. No matter what you do, no matter you give them money, then you make sure they got a job, they pay their bills, but they are never ever satisfied. They don't understand that their breakthrough is coming. All they want to do is dwell on the negative. So they just stay there. But those of us who believe in God through Jesus Christ, we know that we will not stay at a Saturday moment. We know that Sunday is coming. We know that the resurrection moment is coming. We are the thinkers that think the thought that creates the thing. Even if you didn't say that, you better think it. You better think that way. You better think. And you know, as a matter of fact, I've learned that when I am in the midst of my difficult moment, I think of a brighter day.
Yes.
I will not dare allow the world to get me to think of darkness.
Say them.
Why? Why would I succumb to the doubt of darkness when Jesus has already shown me the great light? And so that's what's happening. Jesus is going towards the cross. He's dying, and the disciples are now worried about what in the world are we going to do? Peculiar though. You know, the women. It's hard. You know, women are faithful. You know, when women got a good man, it's hard to get them to run somewhere. You know, when I said good man, a good media like Jesus Christ, you know, that's what I mean, y'all. So while the others were in the upper room experiencing, was Mary and Mary and a couple of disciples hanging around the cross, but they had one foot pointed towards Jerusalem, going back to where the women were standing there weeping and wailing. Because no matter what, I'm here to tell you, no matter what you're going through right now, you hold on to the very last minute.
Yes.
Giving up is always too soon.
Yes, it is.
Definitely.
always too soon. You hold on to the very last minute. I know your Saturday looks dark. I know your Saturday looks bleak. I know that all hell is broken loose in your life, and I know you're trying to figure out when you're going to go with your next step, what tomorrow's going to bring, and all that. But I guarantee you that if you hold on to your faith, your Sunday breakthrough moment is coming.
Yes.
Those who held on. Judas is swinging in a tree somewhere. That's the truth. Because he betrayed.
That's right.
See, Judas wasn't betraying Christ. Judas betrayed himself.
Yes.
Because see, when you don't hold on long enough.
Yes.
Until your change comes.
Because see, change is coming.
Yes. Never.
Change is going to come your way.
Amen.
And it's for the good. The Bible says God works. All things work together. All things work together. The death of Christ is working together. Everything is working together for the good of those who work.
Who love.
So you're going to have your Friday. You're going to go through your Friday moment. You better have some friends or a praying place to go to. You're going to go through your Saturday. All hell is getting ready to break loose. And you're going to feel like your feelings are not that. You're going to feel like you want to give up. But you hold on because Sunday's coming.
Yes, it is.
Sunday is coming. The God in you understands that. You are God. Let me say that one more time.
Yes.
We talked about this. When
yes.
you were born, God blew breath into you,
moved
the
right.
womb. The life was blown into you. God blows God's self into you.
Yes.
See, you keep dwelling on everything, all other parts of you other than the God of you.
Yes. Yes. Mm.
You dress this up, y'all look nice, your hair look nice, your makeup look nice, all that look nice. But the God in you
right.
cannot be neglected.
There you
right.
go.
Right. So you are God. You carry around. You represent God. As a matter of fact, you are a God, God's self.
Yes.
Not that it's a hollow heart, because y'all are so used to praying and looking at God, and you know, we want to look up for God. No, God's right here. The essence of who I am is God. If it had not been that way, I could not breathe. I would not have why I would have no being.
Yes.
This is just an outer shell that housed the God in me.
Right.
Y'all understand that?
Okay.
And so all you need to do is activate the God. Because you're going to go through something.
Yes.
My last point is this. You will face death multiple times.
That's right. It's the truth.
But you will always be resurrected.
Yes.
You will face death multiple times. And I'm glad about there's some things that I have to die to in my life in order for me to become what God is helping me to become. There's some things I have to give up in my life. There's some things I have to lay down in my life. There's some things I have to get rid of. All those are moments of death. But every time I lay down in death, I got up anew.
Amen.
Your Sunday is coming. Y'all hold on and hold out. I don't care what you're going through. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand. Praise Him for you now. It is resurrection Sunday. I want to do this. Come on, musicians.